News Review from BBC Learning English.
Hello and welcome to News Review, the programme where we bring you the language you need to talk about the news. I'm Finn and I'm joined by Neil. Hi, Neil.
Hi there, Finn.
Tell us about today's story.
Got a sad story that turns into a happy story and it involves a famous building.
Right, interesting. I think we need to know a little bit more, so let's listen to this BBC World Service news bulletin.
A replica of the 2,000-year-old Arch of Triumph, destroyed by the Islamic State group in the ancient Syrian city of Palmyra last year, will be unveiled in London today. The replica has been built from marble with a computer-controlled drill, programmed with 3D images of the original. The group behind the project, the Institute for Digital Archaeology, hopes the technology can be used to rebuild parts of Palmyra, which has been recaptured by government troops.
So this is a story about an arch which was destroyed by Islamic State militants, and it's now been made again and is going to be displayed here in London.
Great. So, Neil, I know you've been looking into this story and reading some of the headlines and picking out language that you feel is really useful. What have you chosen today?
The three words that I keep seeing are recreate, unveil, and on display.
Okay, let's define those three. Recreate means simply to make or create once again. To unveil, we often use it about a venue or an exhibit or a work of art. It means to officially open this to the public in a ceremony, often where a covering is removed. And finally, on display means put in a place where people can see it. Something's on display, it's put in a place where people can see it. Neil. Tell us about the headlines that these are appearing in.
Okay, so that word recreated here in the Mail Online, the headline, Palmyra Arch to be recreated in London's Trafalgar Square. So re at the beginning of a word, meaning to do again. Other examples of that, so we've got recreate, rebuild, redo.
Reconstruct.
Reconstruct.
Reappear. Reconstitute.
Yes.
It's quite a long one. Reconsider, to think again. But this prefix re can also be slightly misleading sometimes, can't it? Or what looks like the prefix re isn't always
exactly.
Prefix re.
For example, recover. If you go for a long jog and you're really tired, you need to recover. That is not connected to covering something. However, there is a sense that you can, at a time you can use the word to recover, meaning to put a cover on something. But there is a little difference in pronunciation.
So after my jog, I need to
recover.
But when I want to put a cloth over the cake I've just baked once again to protect it, I
recover.
Fantastic. Great. So that was the prefix re. Coming up next, I believe we have the prefix un.
That's right. Another prefix here in the word unveiled. The headline, LBC website, that's a radio station in London, Syrian arch unveiled in Trafalgar Square.
So a veil, it's the original meaning of a veil is a piece of cloth, of material that usually covers something. A bride's face traditionally is covered by a veil on her wedding day and it's removed when she kisses her groom.
Yes, that's a kind of literal meaning. We tend to use this now when there isn't actually a curtain or a piece of cloth involved. It just means to put on display for the first time. So, for example, a footballer is bought by a club. Let's say Gareth Bale, Welsh footballer. He went to Real Madrid.
For a lot of money.
And after for a lot of money, a record amount of money at the time. And when they wanted to show him to the public for the first time, they unveiled him. That doesn't mean
that they actually
that he was behind a
removed
curtain.
Some curtains and saw Gareth Bale waiting. Yeah. No, sadly not. So that's unveil. Great. Yeah. So you could say that they also put him on display in a sense, couldn't you?
You could say that, and that is exactly the expression we have here in our next headline from Sky News website. Palmyra Arch on display in Trafalgar Square, meaning that it's in a state of display.
Right, and being shown to the public, it's on display.
Yeah.
And this isn't a prefix, this is a preposition really, isn't it? On display. We see this on in other people expressions too, that are kind of set expressions.
Going back to footballers, we could say that a footballer's on loan. So let's go back to Gareth Bale.
Let's do that.
He's there at Real Madrid. And maybe he's not having such a good time and they want him to go and play for what's considered to be an inferior club. So, for example, you know, he could be playing for Real Madrid. He's not very good. And then they send him out on loan to, let's say, Aberdeen.
Right. A club close to my heart. Thank you, Neil. So he'd be on loan.
Yeah, that's right.
At Aberdeen for that period.
Your favourite group, music group, might be doing a series of concerts. Mm-hmm. We would say that they're on tour.
As they travel around.
Yeah.
You could say they're touring, but we often say they are on tour.
And our colleague, Rob.
Yes.
He likes his holidays.
He loves a good holiday, Rob. He's frequently...
on leave.
Yes. On holiday. On leave.
On holiday. And we hear that used a lot in our office.
Is he on holiday today?
I think he is on leave.
Probably is, isn't he?
Yeah.
Well, let's get back to today's story. Listen out for the prefix re here in this report by the BBC reporter Naomi Grimley.
This is the sound of a computer-controlled drill chiselling away at a block of marble. The machine was programmed with 3D images of the original 2,000-year-old arch, so the texture of the stone could be replicated. It's a collaboration between experts from Oxford and Harvard universities and Dubai's Museum of the Future. The group hope technology like this might help rebuild parts of Palmyra, but some classical scholars think the replica arch is a waste of time and money.
So that was the BBC's Naomi Grimley. And now it's time to look at our question that we posed on Facebook, which, as usual, is a language-related question. We asked, which phrasal verb means demolish? Is it A, knock down, B, knock through, or C, knock out? Neil?
We got a good response on Facebook, and we had the full range of answers.
Very nice.
Laura Puglia said, I think it's to knock down that means to demolish. Meanwhile, Lepidoptera says probably B, knock through, and Afghan Bakhtar said C is the right answer. Knock out means demolish.
We've had an A, a B, and a C.
Yeah, and the right answer is the first one I mentioned, Laura Puglia, who said I think it's knock down, which means to demolish, and she's right.
Fantastic. Well done, Laura, and thank you everyone for taking part in our quiz. Right, Neil, I think there's time to summarise today's language once again, isn't there?
So the words that we looked at were recreate, meaning make or create again, unveil, meaning to officially open in a ceremony, and on display, put in a place where people can see something.
And that is it for this edition of News Review. Thanks for watching, and remember, do visit our website, bbclearningenglish.com, to find more about this story and loads more materials to help you learn English. Bye from me.
Goodbye.
News Review from BBC Learning English.